Here's a definition of indoctrinate. To instruct in a doctrine, principle, ideology, etc., especially to imbue with a specific partisan or biased belief or point of view. Most of us do that with our children, even atheists. An atheist will sometimes say, oh, I would never indoctrinate my children. Oh, yes, you do. We all do.
There's a God who lives in the sky, and if you're bad, he's going to send your naughty little ass to hell to roast and fry for all eternity. So follow the rules in this book, and maybe, just maybe, he will find you worthy of salvation, and he will not cook you for all eternity, because he's a nice guy like that. He loves you. It's the final countdown. Hey, son, I just want to let you know there's a lot of ideas out there. A lot of people claiming to know the answers. I just want you to know that you should always be skeptical of the claims that people make. You should always be careful what you believe, and you should always try to believe what you see evidence for. You shouldn't believe things that are fanciful or unrealistic. You should try to keep your feet grounded in reality, and question everything you're told. You see how when we bypass your little cute semantics games and get to the real heart of the issue, the two things really aren't that comparable. An atheist gives his children tools for looking at the world. A Christian gives his child a prefabricated view of reality. That is indoctrination.
Okay, so I received a couple messages from people asking me to elaborate on the vanilla yogurt dessert that I was kind of replicating from McDonald's. I don't have the blueberries, so I thought I would tell you how I do mine.
Fuck. This is just dumb. This is just boring. Who could conceivably give a fuck? Oh, how do you make a parfait? You mix fruit and yogurt. Go fucking figure. Oh, wow. That's informative. Thanks.
They're pasta sides. You can, see this is like 210 calories a serving. Now, I make it with water and they come out just fine.
Woohoo! Let's get this party started! This shit's fun!
Boom, 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 da-na-na-na. Boom, 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 da-na-na-na. Seriously, I mean, like, that clip compresses so much boredom and just a complete lack of anything interesting into such a small space.
They're the pasta sides! They have 210 calories and I make them with water and they turn out just fine!
I mean, like, you're the kind of annoying jackass that if you start talking to this person in the supermarket, you just look for an excuse to go to the next aisle. It's like, hey, I have hemorrhoids, I need to go get some Preparation H, but I'll see you later.
It seems to be working pretty good. There it went.
See what this is? This is... What is this?
Much like my finger. Once I pierced it and released that pressure, you know, instantly things started feeling better. But I could have just let it go for the next 4 or 5 days and it would have been tender and slowly gotten better and ultimately healed itself with probably no long-lasting repercussions. But in our relationships, when we sin against people, we harm people and hurt them.
Wow, that's kind of a stretch. I mean, that's like I make a video of me taking a shit and then I'm like, yeah. I took that shit, and it felt good, for a little while. But you know, even though a shit feels good going out of your ass, that doesn't necessarily mean that a dick would feel good going into your ass. Therefore, don't be gay. You know, I stab myself in the finger and bleed profusely for several minutes, and hey, there's an Aesop fable in there somewhere. No, there's not. Leave it alone. This doesn't need to be on YouTube.
Hold on, YouTube! This is TJ here, the Amazing Atheist. Now, I personally heard you, Jesus freak, say that gay people go to hell instantly.
Wow, that totally sounds like me, because I have that hillbilly accent. You going to hell, boy. I tell you what, everything, blah, blah, blah. I'm an Amazing Atheist up in this day, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, that sounds like me. I mean, what's next? Like, this is my impression of you, Jesus freak. I'm Jesus freak.
I am so manly. You will not defy the manliness of the Jezuzfreek. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's my impression of you. If that's your impression of me, then that's my impression of you. Okay.
Being like that at all. I never said that being homosexual automatically makes you go to hell. I never said...
Well, truth don't really matter now, does it? It's what TJ says. TJ says you said it, so I got more subscribers. They're gonna believe me over you.
So instead of debating me and what I actually said, Jezuzfreek makes up a fictional version of me that says completely ludicrous things and proceeds to defeat that, all while complaining that I have taken him out of context and misrepresented what he said. Wow, that is powerful hypocrisy, and that is incredible stupidity. I guess that what I'm trying to say is that your videos are no good. But you know what? That's not even that big of a deal. This is hard. Most people aren't good at it. Nothing wrong with that. Another thing I'm trying to point out is that you're not very intelligent. You're stupid. You're not a very smart man, and you say really incredibly stupid things. But that's okay, because this is America. And if you can't be stupid in America, where can you be stupid? And I suppose that since neither of these two traits of yours are all that uncommon, they're not really much ownage. They're just kind of reminding you your place. Here's the ownage. Your videos are boring. Abysmally so. They are supernaturally boring. And I realize, Jezuzfreek, that that's why I've had so much animosity towards you for so long. Because you're just so mild-mannered and dull. And plenty of people are boring, sure, but you are just exceptional, sir. You have yourself a fine day there, Jezuzfreek.